away with a little intro to show you that strap locks are worth it, because I'm Dagan from PMTVUK, and today we're going to be doing a strap lock shootout. And you've got this to look forward to. Now, I wholly believe, right, that the humble strap lock is one of the most important things in a guitar rig. Everyone should have strap locks. Like me right now with my American Deluxe Strat. Absolutely fine. I trust them a bit. These aren't going anywhere. And in this video, we'll be talking about the pros and cons of some of the most popular ones, if you're considering buying strap locks, because there are a few different kinds and flavors of strap locks out there. And obviously doing the ultimate test with some guitar spins in a bit, which is going to be a rake of fun. Obviously, if you want to get yourself any of the ones I've chat about, in the description box down below, they're all linked, so you can check them out at pmtonline.co.uk. And in a nutshell, the nature of a strap lock, all of these do the same thing, because a strap lock locks your strap on your guitar. I'm going to keep doing this until I cry, until something happens, until the wood erodes over 400 years. But yeah, they just lock the strap on the guitar, and there's a few different ways in which they can do it, and each of these strap locks we're going to talk about today have their own little unique way of doing it. But 90% of the time, they have a little doohickey that you clip onto the strap itself, and you replace the button on your guitar with a little button from the factory, from Schaller, from Dunlop, from Daddario, and they click in together, thusly, making everything stay just as it should. And as if by magic, I've just got 10 of my favorites to the left of me right now. 10 strap locks, which all do the same job, a very important job, and that's to keep your guitar on your body, on your person. If you're a gigging musician, or you play standing up a lot, or even if you play standing up a lot, because for example, where is it? And the strap I use for a lot of PMT videos, this wonderful Dunlop strap, it's excellent. But I use this every day, and I have done for nearly 2 years now. And the button's getting a bit frayed at the end there. Guitars aren't going to fall, but if I ever want to play with this live, I'd have to use a strap lock. And there's nothing worse than having your pride and joy hit the deck on stage. Not only for your own ego, but for the guitar itself. It can ramp up quite an expensive repair bill. So for the price of some of these strap locks, or even a couple of beers, I'm going to talk about that in a second, you can get your guitar locked onto your strap, I should say, and you can take it off if you want. There are people like Phil X out there. Everyone knows a bit of Phil X, where he just drills his straps to his guitars and they live on the guitars. So that's totally fine if you want to do that as well. But sometimes it's fun to take guitar straps off and change them around and stuff, and these are the best bits of kit to do that with. Right, let's start with one of my favorites. Well, my actual favorite, the Schaller strap lock. So the Schaller strap lock works as, like I said, as traditional strap lock does. There's a piece that goes onto the strap itself through the little hole, and there's a piece that replaces the button on your guitar, the regular strap button. There's a couple of different variants. They've recently just changed the design a few years ago, where there's little thumb wheels which attach the little clip bit to the strap. I'm going to call this bit the button, where previously it was a little bolt. That's a new design. It's very fancy, but I've got the old school bolt design. And one of the reasons why I love these so much is the fact that there's a little U-shape for the connector that goes on the button. So that goes in on the guitar, slide it up, and that isn't going anywhere until you pull this little pin and it pulls out the inside bit in between the U bit, and then your strap comes off. These are my favorite strap locks. They have been for a very long time, and that's the reason why, because it's a fail-safe. Nothing bad is ever going to happen. I've seen people like slam them on the floor too hard and snap the end bit off. That does suck, because that means the strap is now stuck to that guitar unless you want to drill it out. But even if that happens, your strap's not going to come off. Nothing bad's going to happen. It's a very, very cool, fail-safe way to keep your guitar on you. And they're really easy to use. They look cool. I just personally have always loved Schaller strap locks. Another thing to consider with these as well is the actual size of the buttons that goes on the guitar. I love them, but they are a bit small. So if you were to use a regular strap, if you didn't want to rock your strap lock for whatever reason, they are a bit small. Compared to their competitors. But yeah, I love Schaller strap locks. They're awesome. Now let's see how well they actually fare when put under extreme conditions. So I thought we'd come somewhere where I can really test how good these strap locks are. Have a bit of fun with the guitar, throw it around a bit. So I've come to the nice soft ground of Newcastle upon Tyne's Town Moor, my hometown, where this ground is graced with cows and hopefully no dents from the tip of this guitar. We're gonna do some guitar spins with this wonderful thing. This guitar has been with me for a little while. It's our test guitar here at PMT. I've had it for a little while, and it's been buried underground for a week and a bit when we were showing off how awesome Dunlop cleaning products are. I buried it in my garden for like 2 weeks or something, then brought it back to life by cleaning it, and it's lovely. So now, let's hope you don't touch the ground. Let's start with these shaller strap locks. One thing I will say is if you want to do great guitar spins, it's better to get something like a Strat that's got the elongated top horn, and the strap button, crucially, is on the top right there. It works with Telecasters and stuff as well, but I've tried it in the past with SGs, where the strap button's on the back, the top right here, that one always stays where it is, but on the back right there. And when you throw it up, I don't know if it's classed as a center of gravity, but everything's kind of off, and it kind of just goes where it wants to go. The inertia's not very smooth, if you know what I mean. You might end up hitting your bass player, or the singer, or a cow in the back of this field, so it's best to get a guitar with a strap button on a longer top horn like this. So the cool thing about these modern day shallers when you change the strap button is the older ones, the ones I'm used to, but these are the fancy new ones, they all come as one unit. So the screw is built into the strap button itself. So previously you had to screw it in like the rest of them pretty much, where the button itself was loose, screwing through it. But now with these ones, it comes with an Allen key wrench. So you use an Allen key and screw it in. So that helps massively with keeping everything where it should be. Nothing's gonna come loose or spin around pretty much. If it does come loose, you can tell immediately, but hopefully it won't. So these wonderful new shallers come with the super easy thumb wheels to make everything nice and tight. So you haven't always got to check it with a wrench and stuff. Just keep it nice and tight, and there's a little hole through it. So you can tighten it up, you want to put a little Allen wrench through and a little grub screw at the back here. Like I say, I love them and they're super secure. So here we are with the shallers, and like I said, that little U bit, the clip you put on your strap, is a great little bit of extra security to make sure everything is tight and where it should be. Like I keep saying, I've used shallers for years, and I've been doing guitar spins on big stages, small stages, and they've never, ever let me down. So as of right now, shallers, please don't let me down. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You can be as crazy as you want with shallow strap locks, and they're super easy to use. The other, I believe, most popular strap lock on the entire planet is the Dunlop strap lock. Now these are a bit bigger and a bit more rugged than the shallows. Not necessarily rugged, they're just a bit bigger and bigger. The way these work is exactly the same as the shallows in the sense that this part replaces the button on your guitar, and this little guy here goes in your strap. So there's this little plug bit goes through the hole of the strap, you put the washer on, and a little clip, and that clips onto your strap. And the way it goes in which on the guitar, the way in which it goes on the guitar, plugs in like that, not going anywhere. If you want the strap to come off, press the pin, don't pull it like you do on the shallows. There we go. And one cool thing to know about these as well is, compared to the shallows, the actual button that goes in your guitar is like a regular size button. So if you do want to use a regular strap, it's a bit more secure than, say, the shallows, but each to their own. I like the shallows, everyone likes the Dunlop. It's up to you. So the Dunlop ones are probably the most secure when it comes to actually staying onto your strap, the clips anyways. It's ideal to use some pliers and stuff because the tension of this actually keeps all this little thing together. And I know it's probably best to use tools for the other ones as well, to tighten bolts and that, but you can do it finger tight. But with this, you actually do need some pliers. I'm dropping them everywhere. One side goes in to the strap hole. Bit fiddly, but totally worth it. The big washer goes on, and then the little clip with the tension goes around there and keeps everything nice and snug, just like that. So the Dunlops now, push them straight in to the buttons, which again, the buttons are great if you just want to use a regular strap as well. There's plenty of space on there. Press them in, good to go. Again, one of the first strap locks, these ones to come out from the fine folk at Dunlop. Like the rest of them, they're all going to work an absolute treat. Yeah, round and round we go. Oh yeah. Not the greatest guitar spins in the world, but hopefully it's shown off just how well these Dunlop strap locks do. I'm going to continue on the line of regular strap locks and then get a little bit more off-piste towards the end. Next up we have the Ernie Ball strap locks. So many companies make strap locks in all different kinds of shapes and sizes, but they all do the same thing. They all lock your strap on. Fender actually do some as well, which are pretty much identical to the Ernie Ball ones. So these work in a very similar way to the Dunlops and the shallows. This replaces the button on your guitar. This bit clips on your strap. There's a little nut on this one though, as opposed to a clip like on the schaller. So you undo the nut, pop this on your strap, tighten the nut and you're good to go. Pops in, and instead of pressing a button or pulling out a pin on the Ernie balls, there's a little squeezy bit either side, and it comes off like that. When the squeeze isn't squeezed, that's not going anywhere, as you can see right here.
So the Ernie ball ones are kind of similar to the Dunlops in the sense that they go through and you've got the little washer here that goes on the back, but instead of a little tension retainer clip thing, it's just a standard bolt. So screw that on the washer, tighten it up with a pair of pliers, and you're good to go.
So a lot of these share a very similar system, and the Ernie balls are no different. So press them in, it activates some pins inside which grip to the inside of the strap button, and then press a little doohickey and it all comes apart. The Ernie balls though are absolutely solid. They don't protrude out too much. Looks to me like they're doing the trick, eh? A bit of neck burn on that one, but that's what we're here for. We're here to do proper science. Does the job for me, right there. Next up, sticking with the regular kind of strap locks, got the Dodario strap locks right here. Now these are funky little things that look like an Apple product. They come in a wonderful little box. You kind of open them up like jewelry. Look at that, how cool is that? So these again, work in the same sense. Comes with a little button that you pop in your guitar, replacing the strap button that it comes with, and two wonderful parts which actually screw into each other. So it's the easiest to install the Dodario one, in my humble opinion. You don't need any extra tools or Allen keys and whatnot. So basically you pop your strap, little guy right here, through the little hole, screw in. There's a nifty little line there as well, which I enjoy because it actually digs into the strap as well. If that little line, the little protruding bit of metal wasn't there, it would spin all around your strap. So the fact that's there, it's neat. You tighten it up as much as you can, and once it's tight around the strap, you'll see the little pin sticking out the front right there. Now this is probably the most advanced unit of the bunch right here, because that clips on the outside of the little pin there. So it's quite hard to do when it's not on a strap. So right there, it's a little pin. Is that zooming in okay, Alex?
Yeah.
The little pin action right there, that is what keeps the strap on. So that clips over the top of the button and pull it out by pulling the Dodario logo itself. That pulls a pin out and you're good to go. Again, super easy to get on and off. The one thing I will say about these is it's a bit fiddly to pull them out because with warm, sweaty hands on stage, the little grips at the side might not be very good, but in essence, that's also great as well, because once this is on, this isn't going nowhere unless you want it to.
So now for the Dodarios, I notice most straps come with a little line up the top here, which allows you to put it over the strap button on your guitar. And Dodario thought of that with the way these are constructed. So through the hole, it's this is the most kind of streamlined, less cumbersome version. Everything lines up with a little hole right there, as you can see. And all you do, screw in the little Dodario screw. And those little ridges make it super tight when you want. As easy as that.
So the Dodario ones are some of the easiest to use and I believe one of the best looking ones. Like aesthetically, they're very, very pretty things and they hold their own just like the big lads. This is quite a modern design for a strap lock and I think they're holding their own absolutely great, but let the swing be the judge. That was crap. Crap guitar, so I get booed off stage if I did that on stage. Works a treat. Next up we have one that I'm unfortunately not going to spin around my neck, and those are the Dodario elliptical end pins. So these, if you don't want to use strap locks and you like going changing straps quite a bit and whatnot, these lovely little diamond shaped strap buttons harken back to the Northern era Gibsons of the 70s. Like the Adam Jones Les Pauls you can buy these days are 70s tributes in a sense, and they have them as well. So in the 70s, Gibson made and other companies like Yamaha, I think Yamaha had them, diamond shaped strap buttons. And as long as you're not crazy, your strap isn't going anywhere, but I'm not gonna spin that around my head. Now let's keep talking about the strap locks, which are a bit, let's say, less intrusive than the Dunlops or the Schallers and stuff like that. We haven't got to replace the button on your guitar or attach anything to your strap. These are what you can use when you want to either keep changing straps or you're not really that fussed for whatever reason. The first one I want to talk about are the Dunlop lock straps. Now, besides the schallers, I've used these for ages in videos. When I'm borrowing someone's guitar and I don't want to drill into it and put strap locks on, that's a good shout as well. When you don't want to drill and change things on the guitar, some of these options are fantastic. So yeah, these are just little affordable bits of plastic. They come in sets of three, I think, in case you lose one of them, with a little circle inside, and you can spin it and notice the circle gets smaller. And it's as simple as when it's at the biggest setting, popping it over your strap and giving it a twist, so like 180 degrees, so it's the opposite of where it was, the little circle bit gets smaller, and Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your aunt. You haven't had to do anything to your guitar. You've got your favourite strap, you haven't got to clip anything to it. And you've got a strap lock. How awesome is that? And again, they're super affordable. Everything's linked in the description box down below. It's a great way to keep your strap on without having to drill into your pride and joy.
So one thing I will say about these, over time they do become looser when you twist them, but they're so affordable. You can just get loads of them and stuff. So they're both on the guitar now. Doing pretty great. That's never not going to be terrifying. Yeah. Oh, I thought it was going to go there. I thought it was going to go. That's a pass for the lock straps for me.
Next up, a really cool one from the fine folk at the Dario. Now say you just want to, you're not really fussed about your strap or strap locks and stuff like that, but you don't want your guitar to fall on the deck. Dario make an auto lock strap with a strap lock built into the bloody clip of it. How crazy is that? And it's as simple as this. Watch. You watching, Alex?
Watching.
Ridiculous thing. And to get it off, boom. Just like that. Clips on your guitar. I probably feel like I'm doing a cooking show now. Just like that. Look how easy it is to make lasagna. There we go. Lasagna made. Show your friends. Guitar spin for as long as the day is long. Let's see how well it fares.
These are the Dario auto locks, and they're so easy to use, like you've seen. Clip right on the strap. It's not going anywhere. Have a bit of fun with it. Ah! And you can do a lot with these from the factory, straight from Dario. Let's see how they do. That's good for me. That's very good for me. I think that's a proper good test of the Dario auto lock strap locks.
Aye, right. Next up, let's go super old school. Now, there is one more old school method in this list, but the method that I love, and lots of metal players today love, Zach Wilde loves it, Wes Borland loves it, Edward Van Halen loves it. It is, of course, the old school clip and the eye hook in the guitar. Literally just putting one of them in your guitar in like a little dog collar kind of clips. Edward was super famous for this. It's the reason I've done it on certain guitars and stuff, and I've got this tribute right here that I made. That, ladies and gentlemen, isn't going anywhere. The eye hooks themselves are about that long, and they're really thick. So once that gets drove into the wood right there, that's not going anywhere at all. It's a really old school way of doing it. It's really cool in my opinion. It's not for everyone because it is a bit rattly, but that's the Edward Van Halen method. You can buy these now. Buy these now, like Eddie Van Halen branded ones. I got this from like a pet shop and a hardware store, but yeah, that's a strap lock you should consider if you want to be absolutely rad on stage. So the whole clip and eye hook design of the famous Eddie Van Halen strap lock, let's call it that, is probably the most robust because they're definitely not going anywhere. However, like I said at the start with doing the SGs, having the strap put on the back with SGs, the inertia not really going right and the gravity kind of being off. The Kramer 5150 has a strap put on the back here because that's where Ed had his, and this isn't going to go well. Plus the strap's made of leather. It's not going to go anywhere, but I don't think I can do a guitar spin with it. No, you can't, but because it is the eye hooks and stuff, it's not going bloody anywhere. Now for the penultimate strap lock on this list, probably the most iconic in not only the way it looks, but also the way it functions and how awesome it is at keeping your strap on your guitar or keeping the guitar on your strap, whichever way you want to look at it. It is, of course, the DiMarzio clip lock strap. just simply iconic. This is mine right here on my old 87 Kramer Pacer Custom 2. It's been on there for years and not going anywhere at all. It's ridiculous. Lovely, lovely thing. Essentially, it's quite cool. This is one of the Steve Vai ones, like one of the Pier ones. Very nice and gold and black. But yeah, you screw these onto your guitar. These little tags right here, you can get them in leather, you can get them in chrome, you can get them in nylon. There's so many signature straps. Jim Root has a signature strap. I said Steve Vai does as well. You can get snakeskin, you can get cheetah, panther covered ones. You can do a lot. Strap them onto your guitar. And they've got the little clip, the lovely little DiMarzio clip lock. Not going anywhere. Not going anywhere at all. One thing I will say about these as well is careful when you put them down, because I have seen, the only time I've ever seen these break, again, I've never broken one myself, but I have seen them break, people putting the guitar down and it's slamming on the floor and cracking the plastic. But besides that, they're one of the greatest straps to ever live, and they're really good at hoying around your neck. So here we are with the iconic DiMarzio clip lock strap, and you'll notice how much faith I've got in this, because I'm not using the test guitar, I'm using my very own vintage 1987 Kramer Pacer Custom 2, which I've had for many years, and I've done guitar spins with this many times. So hopefully, it doesn't let me down now. Swear to God, it's seriously one of the best in the biz, if it doesn't get caught on my jacket. And yeah, this is the DiMarzio clip lock. I knew you wouldn't let me down. I knew you wouldn't let me down. Bit of a ropey guitar spin in this wind, but seriously one of the best in the biz, the DiMarzio clip lock strap. Now, last but certainly not least, we have the most old school method of attaching the guitar strap to your guitar and making sure it doesn't come off. And that is, I couldn't find any Grolsch, but it is famously the Grolsch bottle beer cap thing, the little washer thing. Companies make these now. Joe Bonamassa sells them in packets. Fender make them as well. And you've got to get a bottle like this. What's this? Gola? How do you pronounce that? Gola? Gola?
Gola?
Gola? But yeah, Grolsch are famous for doing these little kind of tops, which ping off like that. But what we want, besides that delicious, delicious beer, is the little rubber washer right here. That's all we want. That guy right there. And what this is, Joe Bonamassa still uses this to this day, and so many iconic guitarists that have old fancy guitars like vintage Strats and Les Pauls and Gretsches and stuff, but just get these guys and do this with them. Obviously guitars have two strap locks, so you need to buy two beers, don't you? So there we go. Alex has never seen this done before as well. You'll be buying so much Grolsch after this and doing so many guitar spins. So the guitar strap goes on, and with the little Grolsch cap, with it being rubber, you can stretch them. So just stretch it over like that. And as long as you're not daft, it will stay put. It'll stay exactly where you want it to be. So this is more, obviously if you do ride it, it is rubber, it will go, it will expand and contract. But if you've got a strap on your guitar and you're scared of bending down and your strap coming off when you're messing with pedals and stuff, or you just want to keep it on so you can easily grab out a guitar case and stuff, great method. Unbelievable method. And squeaky and smells like beer as well. It's excellent. The most old school method in this list, and one of my personal favorites. Just because it's got the nice bit of history and the nice bit of, it's just kind of wholesome, isn't it? And you get to have a beer while you do it as well, while you look after your guitar. Fantastic. I'm gonna say these ones are some of the most recognizable as well. Again, Bonamassa and Eric Johnson and stuff. You see these little red rubber circles on the strap, and everyone's like, what's that on the strap? It's a Grolsch rubber beer thing, or one of the modern day Fender ones or Joe Bonamassa branded ones. But most of the time it's a beer lid, that's how you can tell. So now for the old school famous Grolsch bottle tops. And like I was saying, there are brands like Fender that make these kind of little rubber washers, and they're a lot more durable and a lot more robust than the old school Grolsch washers. However, I want to go old school. I know it's not Grolsch, but it's the same thing. So the washer comes off the beer, over your standard strap button, like so, and it keeps everything nice and where it should be. So this is a strap lock solution for the guys and gals that are worried about bending down to change pedals and stuff, like I said, and they want the strap coming off. I wouldn't recommend it for a lot of heavy spinning and stuff. I've been through a lot with this guitar and I really don't want it to fly into the next field over, but here we go. Nearly, nearly all the way.
No, 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 no!
And now for an added bonus strap lock solution, which works amazingly thanks to every musician's best friend, duct tape. Use whatever strap you want, whatever strap button you want, used by pop punk bands since, well, pop punk bands, rock bands, metal bands, forever. Let's get some duct tape and strap the absolute hell out of your strap. So many amazing bands have used this iconic technique, and it's pretty intense, but it's not going anywhere at all. And it looks badass as well, doesn't it? Oh yeah. So that, ladies and gents, was a strap lock shootout. Let me know what you think. Which one is your favorite? Which one do you recommend for folk to use? Have you got any good experience? Have you got any bad experience with certain strap locks? Comment down below and share the knowledge. Let me know. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube. Everything I spoke about product-wise is linked in the description box down below. We are playing music today on all social media channels. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.